Kennedy in 1962 says it was a big mistake to let Kim Kardashian wear it to the 2022 Met Gala. Marilyn was a goddess. A crazy goddess, but a goddess, Bob. Mackie recently told Entertainment Weekly, she was just fabulous. Nobody photographs like that, and it was done for her. It was designed for her. Nobody else should be seen in that dress. Now 82, Bob was 23 and working as an assistant to designer Jean-Louis when he drew the original sketch for the gown, which bears Jean's name. According to EU, he voiced similar concerns about damage and preservation as those expressed by historians and others when Kim borrowed the dress from the Ripley's Believe It or Not Museum, which previously bought it from Julian's Auctions for $4.8 million. As Alicia Malone, the host of Turner Classic Movies Fashion on Film series, Follow the Thread, told EU after speaking with Bob, taking the dress out of its archival setting in onto Kim jeopardized its preservation potential because even things like oxygen can affect a dress. She added, usually, these outfits are kept very much in controlled environments and we see that with the Met. The Costume Institute is so careful about how they are handling these historic items. So, it was quite alarming that she was able to wear it. I personally wish she wore a replica instead of the real thing. It didn't help matters, EU notes, that Kim announced Shejoni on a crash diet to lose 13 pounds in 3 weeks in order to fit into the piece, particularly given Marilyn's long struggle to be valued for Marethan just her beauty. Kim Kardashian wearing Marilyn Monroe's dress was a big mistake, says its original designer, Bob Mackie. The fashion designer who first sketched the now iconic dress Marilyn Monroe wore when she sang Happy Birthday to President John F. Kennedy in 1962 says it was a big mistake to let Kim Kardashian wear it to the 2022 Met Gala. Marilyn was a goddess. A crazy goddess, but a goddess, Bob Mackie recently told Entertainment Weekly, she was just fabulous. Nobody photographs like that, and it was done for her. It was designed for her. Nobody else should be seen in that dress. Now 82, Bob was 23 and working as an assistant to designer Jean-Louis when he drew the original sketch for the gown, which bears Jean's name. According to EU, he voiced similar concerns about damage and preservation as those expressed by historians and others when Kim borrowed the dress from the Ripley's Believe It or Not Museum, which previously bought it from Julian's Auctions for $4.8 million. As Alicia Malone, the host of Turner Classic Movies Fashion on Film series, Follow the Thread, told EU after speaking with Bob, taking the dress out of its archival setting and onto Kim jeopardized its preservation potential because even things like oxygen can affect a dress. She added, usually, these outfits are kept very much in controlled environments and we see that with the Met. The Costume Institute is so careful about how they are handling these historic items. So, it was quite alarming that she was able to wear it. I personally wish she wore a replica instead of the real thing. It didn't help matters, EU notes, that Kim announced she'd gone on a crash diet to lose 13 pounds in 3 weeks in order to fit into the piece, particularly given Marilyn's long struggle to be valued for more than just her beauty. Tribute to her husband, who died unexpectedly on January 9, 2022. Happy birthday, my love. I miss you beyond words, Kelly wrote beside a gallery of photos in video of the two in Los Cabos. These pictures and videos were taken exactly 1 year ago in Mexico. We always celebrated our birthdays together with a trip. Kelly, who turns 44 this weekend, then switched back and forth in addressing the Full House alum directly and her friends on Instagram. His is the 17th in. Mine is 19th, she said of their birthdays. This last trip was so special. We both celebrated each other so big. You never know when something is going to be the last time, but I am so grateful that he was showered with all of the love he deserves. I pray he can see all of the love he's already getting from around the world today, she continued. Honey, everyone loves you so d**** much. Everyone wants you to know how important and special you are on your special day, and we all celebrate you. You are one of a kind and you certainly made my world go round. She signed off by writing, "I love you more than anything in. Miss you every minute. Your girls and I will hold on tight to each other today. And I know you'd want me to get a martini tonight, so I'll oblige. Happy birthday, honey." Katie Couric, Kevin Nealon, Taylor Lautner, Richard Marx, and other famous friends of the couple sent them both their love in the comments. Bob Saget's wife, Kelly Rizzo, Mark's first birthday since his death. Bob Saget would have turned 66 on Tuesday, May 17th, and the date sparked the late comic's wife Kelly Rizzo to post a moving Instagram tribute to her husband, who died unexpectedly on January 9, 2022. "Happy birthday, my love. I miss you beyond words," Kelly wrote beside a gallery of photos and video of the two in Los Cabos. "These pictures and videos were taken exactly 1 year ago in Mexico. We always celebrated our birthdays together with a trip." Kelly, who turns 44 this weekend, then switched back and forth in addressing the Full House alum directly and her friends on Instagram. "His is the 17th and mine is 19th, she signed off their birthdays. "This last trip was so special. We both celebrated each other so big. You never know when something is going to be the last time. But I am so grateful that he was showered with all of the love he deserves. I pray he can see all of the love he's already getting from around the world today," she continued. "Honey, everyone loves you so d**** much. Everyone wants you to know how important and special you are on your special day, and we all celebrate. You are one of a kind and you certainly made my world go round." She signed off by writing, "I love you more than anything and miss you every minute. Your girls and I will hold on tight to each other today. And I know you'd want me to get a martini tonight, so I'll oblige. Happy birthday, honey." Katie Couric, Kevin Nealon, Taylor Lautner, Richard Marx, and other famous friends of the couple sent them both their love in the comments. Buffalo, NY, that left 10 people dead and injured 3 others on Saturday, May 14th. Sharing photos of 3 of the victims, Jamie, 54, ticked off the many emotions he was struggling with on Monday. "Cannot understand why the color of our skin makes people so angry," he continued on Instagram. "Who knew just being born black would be such a tortuous journey? Our condolences go out to the victims in Buffalo. And I just wonder how many more times you gonna have to say this." 11 of the 13 victims in the shooting were black, while the suspect, an 18-year-old white man named Peyton Gendron, allegedly detailed his plan of attack and described himself as a white supremacist in an online manifesto, according to CNN. Jamie later posted a list of the victims' names and ages. Most were over 60. "Gunned down like animals in cold blood on a live stream. All for the color of the beautiful black skin," Jamie wrote, in part. "What's sad is that this is not anything new. This is our history. This is our present, the desensitization of the black human being. Bless these beautiful people with beautiful black skin," he added. The suspect has been charged with first-degree murder and pleaded not guilty, per CNN. The U.S. Department of Justice is reportedly investigating the attack as a hate crime and an act of racially motivated violent extremism. Jamie Foxx shares emotional response to Buffalo shooting. Jamie Foxx is among the many voices speaking out about the shooting at a grocery store in a predominantly black neighborhood in Buffalo, New York, that left 10 people dead and injured 3 others on Saturday, May 14th. Sharing photos of 3 of the victims, Jamie, 54, ticked off the many emotions he was struggling with on Monday. "Cannot understand why the color of our skin makes people so angry," he continued on Instagram. "Who knew they just being born black would be such a tortuous journey? Our condolences go out to the victims in Buffalo. And I just wonder how many more times you gonna have to say this." 11 of the 13 victims in the shooting were black, while the suspect, an 18-year-old white man named Peyton Gendron, allegedly detailed his plan of attack and described himself as a white supremacist in an online manifesto, according to CNN. Jamie later posted a list of the victims' names and ages. Most were over 60. "Gunned down like animals in cold blood on a live stream. All for the color of the beautiful black skin," Jamie wrote, in part. What's sad is that this is not anything new. This is our history. This is our present. The desensitization of the black human being. Bless these beautiful people with beautiful black skin, he added. The suspect has been charged with first-degree murder and pleaded not guilty, per CNN. The U.S. Department of Justice is reportedly investigating the attack as a hate crime and an act of racially motivated violent extremism. Don't borrow from the bank, borrow from yourself. Add LendingTree. Slideshow continues on the next slide. Don't borrow from the bank, borrow from yourself. Add LendingTree. Zayn Malik, Niall Horan, Liam Payne and Louis Tomlinson. In a new interview with Zane Lowe for Apple Music, the singer reflected on his 1D days, saying he was really lucky to have been part of such a connected group at the time. I think there is very much a respect between all of us if we did something together. And that is something that you can't really undo. And you know, it's like a very deep love for each other, I think, Harry mused ahead of the Friday, May 20th release of his new solo album, Harry's House. While he said he feeds on the energy fans send his way when he's on stage, Harry also spoke in warm terms of the experience performing with a group as opposed to being a solo artist. It just felt so separate from any individual, he said. Later in the chat, Harry pointed to Billie Eilish as part of his inspiration to do something new and different as an artist after 1D. I think being in the band, ID always felt like we were really young, and I had a moment seeing Billie do this at such a young age where I felt like, I am not that young anymore, he explained. And for a while it was, how do you play that game of remaining exciting? Instead of overthinking it in those terms, he said he eventually realized what matters is something else, something Billie helped him see. This is so unbelievably liberating to go, I just want to make good music, he said. That's it, that's what I want to do. And everything else is what it will be. Harry Styles reflects on deep love he still has for 1D members. It's been 6 years since One Direction announced its indefinite hiatus, but time hasn't changed the way Harry Styles feels about Zayn Malik, Niall Horan, Liam Payne and Louis Tomlinson. In a new interview with Zane Lowe for Apple Music, the singer reflected on his 1D days, saying he was really lucky to have been part of such a connected group at the time. I think there is very much a respect between all of us, if we did something together. And that is something that you can't really undo. And you know, it's like a very deep love for each other, I think, Harry mused ahead of the Friday, May 20th release of his new solo album, Harry's House. While he said he feeds on the energy fans send his way when he's on stage, Harry also spoke in warm terms of the experience performing with a group as opposed to being a solo artist. It just felt so separate from any individual, he said. Later in the chat, Harry pointed to Billie Eilish as part of his inspiration to do something new and different as an artist after 1D. I think being in the band, ID always felt like we were really young, and I had a moment seeing Billie do this at such a young age where I felt like, I am not that young anymore, he explained. And for a while it was, how do you play that game of remaining exciting? Instead of overthinking it in those terms, he said he eventually realized what matters is something else, something Billie helped him see. This is so unbelievably liberating to go, I just want to make good music, he said. That's it, that's what I want to do. And everything else is what it will be. With TMZ this week, he's reportedly completed a one-year inpatient rehab program for drug and alcohol addiction and is now sober and continuing his treatment on an outpatient basis. According to TMZ, the star is now living with his wife, Nikki, and son, Phoenix, near his rehab center in Boca Raton, Florida. Bam also tells the outlet he hopes to eventually return to Southern California, where he wants to pursue new projects with other sober skaters. The health update comes after Bam filed suit against his former Jaka Asterisk collaborators, including Johnny Knoxville and Jaka Asterisk Forever director Jeff Tremaine, in May 2021, claiming he was wrongfully terminated from the movie in August 2020. TMZ reported at the time of the filing that Bam claimed he was asked to sign a wellness agreement due to his history of drug and alcohol issues. He alleged he was fired after testing positive for Adderall, despite having been prescribed the drug 4 years to treat his attention deficit disorder. My lawsuit isn't just about compensation, Bam told EU in 2021. It's about treating people with mental health and addiction issues in an honest manner and not taking advantage of their disabilities to rip them off. His former co-star Steve O has said, Johnny and Jeff did what they could to support Bam, but fired him because he failed to stay sober. Bam asked to dismiss the suit on April 14, 2022, indicating those involved had reached a settlement. Bam Margera says he's completed a year-long drug and alcohol rehab program. After settling a lawsuit with his former Jaka asterisk Forever co-stars over the movie in April, Bam Margera shared more good news with TMZ this week. He's reportedly completed a one-year, inpatient rehab program for drug and alcohol addiction and is now sober and continuing his treatment on an outpatient basis. According to TMZ, the star is now living with his wife, Nikki, and son, Phoenix, near his rehab center in Boca Raton, Florida. Bam also tells the outlet he hopes to eventually return to Southern California, where he wants to pursue new projects with other sober skaters. The health update comes after Bam filed suit against his former Jaka asterisk collaborators, including Johnny Knoxville and Jaka asterisk Forever director Jeff Tremaine, in May 2021, claiming he was wrongfully terminated from the movie in August 2020. TMZ reported at the time of the filing that Bam claimed he was asked to sign a wellness agreement due to his history of drug and alcohol issues. He alleged he was fired after testing positive for Adderall, despite having been prescribed the drug for years to treat his attention deficit disorder. My lawsuit isn't just about compensation, Bam told EU in 2021. It's about treating people with mental health and addiction issues in an honest manner and not taking advantage of their disabilities to rip them off. His former co-star Steve O has said Johnny and Jeff did what they could to support Bam, but fired him because he failed to stay sober. Bam asked to dismiss the suit on April 14, 2022, indicating those involved had reached a settlement. BIPOC, Black, Indigenous and People of Color, families from Ukraine amid Russia's war. Hey guys, I am auctioning stuff from my Met Gala look last year too. Raise money to help get BIPOC families out of Ukraine since they're having trouble exiting at the border, Grimes wrote on Instagram this week, referencing reports of racial discrimination and xenophobia at the country's borders. She also shared photos of the pieces, a metallic CHRISHABANAX Dune Harkonnen Maskin Silver Elf Ear Cuffs. The singer and visual artist is one of 50 who've donated to the Ukraine Resistance Auction, hosted by Artsy until bidding closes in May 26. Others participating include Sonic Youth's Kim Gordon and artist Obey Clothing founder Shepard Ferry. Each piece offers a unique interpretation of the theme resistance, Grimes continued in her post. All proceeds will go to Diaspora Relief in Razum, which will use the funds to provide food, shelter, and evacuation support to those in need. Grimes auctions off 2021 Met Gala accessories to support Ukraine refugees, emergency responders. Grimes is auctioning off two pieces from her Dune-centric 2021 Met Gala look to raise money to support emergency response and BIPOC, Black, Indigenous and People of Color, families from Ukraine amid Russia's war. Hey guys, I am auctioning stuff from my Met Gala look last year to raise money to help get BIPOC families out of Ukraine since they're having trouble exiting at the border, Grimes wrote on Instagram this week, referencing reports of racial discrimination and xenophobia at the country's borders. She also shared photos of the pieces, a metallic CHRISHABANAX Dune Harkonnen mask and silver elf ear cuffs. The Sindarind visual artist is one of 50 who've donated to the Ukraine Resistance Auction, hosted by Artsy until bidding closes on May 26. Others participating include Sonic Youth's Kim Gordon and artist Obey Clothing founder Shepard Ferry. Each piece offers a unique interpretation of the theme resistance. Grimes continued in her post, all proceeds will go to Diaspora Relief in Razum, which will use the funds to provide food, shelter, and evacuation support to those in need. BIPOC, Black, Indigenous and People of Color, families from Ukraine amid Russia's war. Hey guys, I am auctioning stuff from my Met Gala look last year too. Raise money to help get BIPOC families out of Ukraine since they're having trouble exiting at the border, Grimes wrote on Instagram this week, referencing reports of racial discrimination and xenophobia at the country's borders. She also shared photos of the pieces, a metallic CHRISHABANAX Dune Harkonnen Maskin silver elf earcuffs. The singer and visual artist is one of 50 who've donated to the Ukraine Resistance Auction, hosted by Artsy until bidding closes in May 26. Others participating include Sonic Youth's Kim Gordon and artist, Obey Clothing founder Shepard Ferry. Each piece offers a unique interpretation of the theme resistance, Grimes continued in her post. All proceeds will go to Diaspora Relief in Razum, which will use the funds to provide food, shelter, and evacuation support to those in need. Grimes auctions off 2021 Met Gala accessories to support Ukraine refugees, emergency responders. Grimes is auctioning off two pieces from her Dune-centric 2021 Met Gala look to raise money to support emergency response and BIPOC, Black, Indigenous and People of Color, families from Ukraine amid Russia's war. Hey guys, I am auctioning stuff from my Met Gala look last year to raise money to help get BIPOC families out of Ukraine since they're having trouble exiting at the border, Grimes wrote on Instagram this week, referencing reports of racial discrimination and xenophobia at the country's borders. She also shared photos of the pieces, a metallic CHRISHABANAX Dune Harkonnen mask and silver elf earcuffs. The Singerand visual artist is one of 50 who've donated to the Ukraine Resistance Auction, hosted by Artsy until bidding closes on May 26. Others participating include Sonic Youth's Kim Gordon and artist, Obey Clothing founder Shepard Ferry. Each piece offers a unique interpretation of the theme resistance. Grimes continued in her post. All proceeds will go to Diaspora Relief in Razum, which will use the funds to provide food, shelter, and evacuation support to those in need. BIPOC, Black, Indigenous and People of Color, families from Ukraine amid Russia's war. Hey guys, I am auctioning stuff from my Met Gala look last year too. Raise money to help get BIPOC families out of Ukraine since they're having trouble exiting at the border, Grimes wrote on Instagram this week, referencing reports of racial discrimination and xenophobia at the country's borders. She also shared photos of the pieces, a metallic CHRISHABANAX Dune Harkonnen Maskin silver elf earcuffs. The singer and visual artist is one of 50 who've donated to the Ukraine Resistance Auction, hosted by Artsy until bidding closes in May 26. Others participating include Sonic Youth's Kim Gordon and artist, Obey Clothing founder Shepard Ferry. Each piece offers a unique interpretation of the theme resistance, Grimes continued in her post. All proceeds will go to Diaspora Relief in Razum, which will use the funds to provide food, shelter, and evacuation support to those in need. Grimes auctions off 2021 Met Gala accessories to support Ukraine refugees, emergency responders. Grimes is auctioning off two pieces from her Dune-centric 2021 Met Gala look to raise money to support emergency response and BIPOC, Black, Indigenous and People of Color, families from Ukraine amid Russia's war. Hey guys, I am auctioning stuff from my Met Gala look last year to raise money to help get BIPOC families out of Ukraine since they're having trouble exiting at the border, Grimes wrote on Instagram this week, referencing reports of racial discrimination and xenophobia at the country's borders. She also shared photos of the pieces, a metallic CHRISHABANAX Dune Harkonnen mask and silver elf earcuffs. The Singerand visual artist is one of 50 who've donated to the Ukraine Resistance Auction, hosted by Artsy until bidding closes on May 26. Others participating include Sonic Youth's Kim Gordon and artist Obey Clothing founder Shepard Fairey. Each piece offers a unique interpretation of the theme resistance. Grimes continued in her post, "All proceeds will go to Diaspora Relief in Razum, which will use the funds to provide food, shelter, and evacuation support to those in need. BIPOC, Black, Indigenous and people of color, families from Ukraine amid Russia's war. Hey guys, I am auctioning stuff from my Met Gala look last year too. Raise money to help get BIPOC families out of Ukraine since they're having trouble exiting at the border," Grimes wrote on Instagram this week, referencing reports of racial discrimination and xenophobia at the country's borders. She also shared photos of the pieces. A metallic CHRISHABANAX Dune Harkonnen Maskin Silver Elf Earcuffs. The singer and visual artist is one of 50 who've donated to the Ukraine Resistance Auction, hosted by Artsy until bidding closes in May 26. Others participating include Sonic Youth's Kim Gordon and artist Obey Clothing founder Shepard Fairey. Each piece offers a unique interpretation of the theme resistance, Grimes continued in her post. All proceeds will go to Diaspora Relief in Razum, which will use the funds to provide food, shelter, and evacuation support to those in need. Grimes auctions off 2021 Met Gala accessories to support Ukraine refugees, emergency responders. Grimes is auctioning off two pieces from her Dune-centric 2021 Met Gala look to raise money to support emergency response and BIPOC, Black, Indigenous and people of color, families from Ukraine amid Russia's war. Hey guys, I am auctioning stuff from my Met Gala look last year to raise money to help get BIPOC families out of Ukraine since they're having trouble exiting at the border, Grimes wrote on Instagram this week, referencing reports of racial discrimination and xenophobia at the country's borders. She also shared photos of the pieces. A metallic CHRISHABANAX Dune Harkonnen mask and silver elf earcuffs. The singer and visual artist is one of 50 who've donated to the Ukraine Resistance Auction, hosted by Artsy until bidding closes on May 26. Others participating include Sonic Youth's Kim Gordon and artist Obey Clothing founder Shepard Fairey. Each piece offers a unique interpretation of the theme resistance. Grimes continued in her post, "All proceeds will go to Diaspora Relief in Razum, which will use the funds to provide food, shelter, and evacuation support to those in need."